February 22nd, 2011. A natural disaster that will live in the memories of so many Kiwis, none more so than those Cantabrians who survived and lost so much. Today, Stats NZ, through the lens of data, looks at what happened to the red and black of Canterbury over the last 7 years.
Building activity increased strongly following the earthquakes, but we do seem to be well past the peak now. In the 7 years following the earthquakes, enough ready-mixed concrete was produced in Canterbury to fill 2,000 Olympic-sized swimming pools. And that concrete can go into anything from roads to foundations for houses to high-rise buildings. In those 7 years, over 36,000 new homes were consented. That's over 10,000 more than in the previous 7 years. And that includes houses, retirement village units, apartments, and townhouses like the ones that are being built here.
Construction prices increased 52% since September 2009. This was larger than the price movements seen in Auckland and New Zealand as a whole. Rental prices increased 18% during the same period as well.
50,000 more people gained employment after September 2012. A lot of these workers worked in retail, trade and accommodation and the construction industries.
Christchurch's population dropped by over 20,000 people in the 2 years to June 2012. In the period of the recovery, we saw a considerable redistribution of the population westward, with areas such as Wigram and Rolleston experiencing high growth. The eastern suburbs in particular got hit hard by liquefaction, and a considerable amount of land was red zoned. From September 2009 to 2017, migrant arrivals hit their lowest point in 2011. From the year ending September 2012 to 2015, they increased year on year. It's estimated that the Christchurch population exceeded its pre-quake level before June last year.
For 6 years until June 2016, retail and hospitality sales increased by 34% in Christchurch. That's 6% higher than the rest of the country.